What is up, YouTube? Wait a second. How come we're invisible?
I don't know. I guess the Sparckman never had time to make any animations today.
I don't care. Like the video and subscribe. I'm gonna go play some Airbox.
Hey there, guys. My name is Sparckman. I'm a game developer. Today we're going to create a 2D Minecraft. Well, or something like it. Let me show you the demo. It's a randomly generated world. Let's bring out our character. And we can start digging. Dig. And you can see that all this is randomly generated. Cut some here at the bottom. If I press 2, I can restart the level. And you can see that a new level is generated. Try it again. I like this one, it's not too bad. See if we can find something. Dig. Alright, so let's open the example file, which you are going to find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is a link down below where you can download the free version. There is also a link to the paid version, which allows you to release commercial titles. Alright, so let's have a look at the assets very quickly. You can see that I'm using 3 counters. You could use variables if you wanted to. I'm using a static object. Here's the pickaxe, which you can change. Here's our character, just a box with eyes. That's his arm. Separate piece. Here's an object to tell where the X coord, and here's the terrain. 3 types of terrain. This one here is just blank. And we have a background. Let's go to the event editor. All right, so we have 3 counters. We have a yellow counter, blue, and red. All right, so if the blue counter is less than 5, lower than 5, and the red counter, less than 6, and the yellow counter less than 30. Change this to the yellow counter. In that case, we're going to add 1 to the yellow counter. Try it out. That goes all the way to 30. We have this green object here, which I missed somehow during the... we're going to use this to create the terrain. So we're going to move this object 32 pixels on the X. Select the object. 32. Make this visible at start. Try it out. And you can see that that works fine. We're also going to create a piece of terrain every time that happens, relative to the position of the green object. Turn out. And you can see that that works fine. Now the directions are set randomly. These are the 4 directions I'm using. So when the terrain's direction is up, then we're going to destroy it. Turn out. That works fine. I'm gonna copy line 1, paste it. So when our yellow counter reaches 30, equals 30, then we're gonna set our yellow counter to 0, and we're gonna add 1 to the blue counter. Try it out. You can see that the blue counter goes up. Copy line 3, paste it, delete the yellow counter, switch the blue counter to equals. We're gonna set these 2 counters to 0, and we're gonna add 1 to the red counter. Delete this here, and we're gonna change the Y position, of the green object, plus 32. Now for the X position, we're gonna use the X position of the blue object. Try it out. Okay, so maybe 30 is a little too much. As for a bigger terrain, let me set this to 5. Try it out. And that builds much faster. Now we're gonna create our character. So when the red counter is equal 6, only one action when this event loops, we're gonna create our character, which is our Minecraft ripoff guy. Try it out. That works fine. It's a platform object, by the way. All right, so if it collides with the background or the terrain, then we make him stop. Try it out. There's our guy. I'm gonna create an always. Scrolling. Center window position relative to our character. Try it out. Here is the randomly generated world. Now he needs his arm. Under the same line, we're gonna set the position of the arm relative to our character. Here it is. Whoa, what is our arm? Oh yes, we need to create the arm. Under line 5, we're gonna create the arm anywhere. There he is, but he can't move his arm. We got this green object here. I'm gonna set the X position of the green object equals the X position of the mouse, and the Y position equals the Y position of the mouse. We have to make this visible so you can see what's happening. Yeah, that works right away. So the arm is always going to look in the direction of the green object. Straight out, you can see that the sort of works already. Let's attach the pickaxe to the arm. We're gonna attach it to the arm position, select position here somewhere by his hand. And under options, I'm going to select the in direction of active object 5, which is the arm. Straight out, that sort of works already. A little closer. It's not too bad there. Let's make the green object invisible. Now collision between the pickaxe and the ground. We're going to add one to the terrain. And when the terrain's value is greater than, say, 5, maybe 4, then we destroy the terrain. Try it out. You can see that that works right away. But we have the only problem we have now is that if you walk by something repeatedly, you eventually break it. So under line 8, we're going to filter this. This is only going to work if the user is holding the mouse key. Move these counters out of the way. And let's start digging. That works fine. Dig. Digging. And you can see that this works not too bad. If you like this video, hit the like button. And if you didn't like the video, smack the dislike button. And now it's time for the first comment and the top comment. And the comment with the most replies was the Awesome Gamer iOS. Whoa, here's the channel. Oh, what is this?
Get my blank skin because I'm not.
And the first comment was Crystal Axe 21. Again. Whoa, what is this?
Kick, punch, it's all in the mind.
Alright, so thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Twitter. And I'll see you in the next episode. Bye now. And now it's coffee time.